Jay Will, you were at this game last night.
Yes, I was, Greeny.
And it was flat out crazy. Kemba Walker and the Hornets taking on the Nets. What a crazy finish. This is Marvin Williams drilling a three to give the Hornets a three-point lead with under 25 seconds to go in regulation. With under 10 seconds left, Spencer Dinwiddie off a jump ball is going to get fouled. Jay Will, he's got to get three foul shots.
A guy that's up for sixth man of the year. He's been one of the most dynamic players for the Nets this season.
He would make all three. And so here we go. Kemba Walker back the other way in the next possession. He's tripped. The foul is called. He goes to the line. He misses the second. Damari Carroll gets the rebound. He flings the ball, and they're going to call a shooting foul on Kemba there.
I couldn't believe it. It was the right call, though. I mean, that's how you play it. You wrap the arm up. It was a great call by Damari Carroll.
All right, so Kemba Walker winds up with free throw opportunities. Okay, he goes to the line again. They're down one. So he's good. Here's the first free throw. And he makes that. So with 1 second left, we're tied. If he makes the next one, they're going to win the game. Hold on, he misses, but wait a minute. They've called a lane violation. So Damari Carroll is going to get one more chance to give his team the lead. But he can't get
it
done.
Damari. Come on.
And so we're going to overtime. Now we're going to fast forward all the way to 0.6 seconds remaining in overtime. Tied at 121. The Nets are inbounding. And watch Dinwiddie here.
All right, first off, what a pass. And then the shot. Oh!
So close. So close, but it doesn't go until we're going to a second overtime, and everyone is very entertained watching this game. As you'll see here, would it have counted? It probably would not have. It doesn't matter because it doesn't go in. LeBron James is loving it, by the way. He's watching the game, and you see his tweet, man, this Hornets Nets game is damn good. I've been watching from the top. It's craziness. It is, and it wouldn't stop there. 10 seconds left in double overtime. Tied at 132. Malik Monk stripped. Joe Harris the other way. Lays it up and good, and then they're going to try and come back. Listen to the buzzer.
Charlotte, 2-point lead for Brooklyn. Walker throws it up at the horn. It's over.
Hold on. That horn went off way, way too soon just then. This is going to be very interesting, Ian.
So Damon Jones, again, you just yelled out what?
Home cooking.
Home cooking. The buzzer goes off. Now, as you'll take another look at this thing here, clearly there's time left. And watch what goes off. It's not the game clock. It's the shot clock that goes off. So the shot clock goes off. The game clock shows there still should be almost 2 seconds remaining. So now we got to get together and figure this thing out. What a crazy night this was in sports. The officials would hull. They would eventually put 1.6 seconds on the clock. And so Charlotte is going to get a chance. In a two-point game, where are they going to go? Here comes Malik Monk. This is for the win. And it does not go. And that's how it ends last night at Barclays. A crazy game. And, oh, by the way, the Nets are really good. They're 9-1 going back to December 7th. You see it on your screen. It's the best record in the NBA over that span in a game that, of course, includes Kemba Walker, who scored 35 in the double overtime loss. His team is right around 500. His is a name you're going to hear a lot in trade conversations. And so we'll talk about whether or not we expect him to get moved as we talk with Jay Will here and take a close look with your iPad at some of the things that make him just so good.
What a beautiful thing about Kemba is he's second most used in the NBA with ball screens. He gets 35 ball screens per game. DJ, how amazing is that?
That's a privilege.
Exactly, right? And he's so compact and dynamic. We're going to break down a play here. And you're going to see as the play comes, you're going to see Marvin Williams is going to come with a little drag screen here on the defensive man, okay? As he comes at the little drag screen, I want you to also see what else is happening as the play develops. You're going to see another screen here by here, Miles, and then you're also going to see Jeremy Lamb flare out to the side, and it opens up this entire area. Now you're talking about Kemba Walker going against Jared Allen, one-on-one, right, which is what the league is. Look at this move. Look how dynamic that step back, that distance he's able to create, and he's a master of the mid-range game, which is why you love Kemba once again. Now, I don't care what anybody says. When you're a guard like Kemba Walker and you see this open floor, it does not matter what my man Spencer Dinwiddie can do defensively. He's not going to be able to stop it. Now, they're going to have another drag ball screen come up by Zeller. It's going to come up from the side, okay? When it comes from the side here, then you're going to watch Spencer Dinwiddie turn his head. Ooh, you try to jump over that screen. I said before, Greeny, he's so dynamic. His ability to shift here and then go here that quick is what makes him such a unique player. And as it goes there, you're going to see ISO, and that's to close out the first half. I mean, just so dynamic with the ball. And here's the thing. He's not going to get the national recognition he deserves. They only have two games on national TV, but Kemba Walker is a transcendent type of player.
And if a contender gets him, how much of a difference maker is he?
I mean, it really changed the balance in the Eastern Conference. I think it's three teams that he could go to right now and propel them to the top four in the East. One is the Indiana Pacers. I think he could go there and be a good piece. He could go to the Miami Heat and do great things. Mm-hmm. And my third, which would be a dark horse, the Detroit Pistons with Blake Griffin and Big Drummond. I think he'll take those all three of those teams to the top four in the East.
He also might get big money from a New York team. Free agency coming up.
One or the other. He's
New
a New York
Knicks
kid.
Or the Brooklyn Nets.
We will see. There's a lot of fans of the Knicks who would certainly like to see that happen.